Stop putting faith in other people. Stop it. Let me repeat that. Stop putting faith in other people. I really mean it. Cut it out. First of all, faith should be reserved for Christ alone, because He is the Lord. He's the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He never fails. He's omniscient. He is God. He is the great I Am. That means that He alone is 100% reliable. He alone cannot be influenced by others. He alone knows everything. He alone sees all possible options. And He alone can make the absolute good decision of what's best and what's most effective. So faith should only be reserved for Christ alone. When it comes to human beings, you can have trust, which is a practical reliance, but only if it's safe. And with quite some folks, I don't recommend you to trust them, because their attitude is untrustworthy. What I see happen is, and this happens amongst people that claim to follow Christ also, and that surprises me the most, is that folks put faith in their spouses, in their parents, who especially parents, in their children, in their teachers, pastors, politicians. They put faith in all except Christ. And yet, when things begin to fall apart, they cry out, "Lord, why is this happening to me? Lord, what did I do wrong?" Christ said that He is the vine, and we are the branches. Who is the vine? Is it your spouse? Is it your boyfriend, girlfriend? Is it one of your parents? Is it mommy or daddy? Is it one of your kids? Is it Uncle Tom, Uncle Ted, Aunt Betty? Who is it? Who is the vine? Who is the vine from which the branches get their quality? Christ is. And you are the branch. So the branch depends on the vine. So if Christ is the vine and you are the branch, that means you depend on Him for your quality. Other people are around because you're a social being, so you need social interaction, but you don't put faith in others. You can invest in others, okay? And you can entrust things to others, and you can provoke people to operate in faith. That's true. And in some cases you do that, but you don't put faith in them. Faith should be reserved for Christ alone. He alone never disappoints. He cannot disappoint, because there is no such thing as disappointment in His kingdom. The powers of darkness only know disappointment. It's the late disappointment in which we have a long-term honeymoon season, but eventually the powers of darkness, who are in opposition to Christ, only know disappointment and frustration. That's all they have. That's why worldly people are seeking relief all the time. Look, in colloquial speech, you can say to someone, "I have faith in you." That's an expression of, "I know you can do it." Okay? I'm not talking about that. You use the word faith there to imply that you have confidence that someone is able to do something. And that's how you encourage someone. I'm not talking about that. When I talk about faith, I'm talking about complete reliance. Okay? That's the context of the word faith in this video. You should have complete reliance only in Christ. So I guarantee you, the moment you invest complete reliance in anything or anyone else, you are trapped. And when you do this, evil spirits will take advantage of you. Other people will take advantage of you. And you'll be left alone, exploited, I don't mean left alone as you're left in East. No, you'll be left behind. Yes, left behind is better. You'll be left behind, exploited, used, and dying. And those that use you will always come up with some excuse to justify what they did because they want to move on. They want to be left alone from the consequences they caused you. So, again, only invest 100% reliance in Christ. When you're confident that someone's able to do something based on facts, then you can say that to someone. And if you use the word faith, because that's the expression, okay, and I can understand it, but real faith, when it comes down to it, only in Christ. I see often that people put faith anything else except Christ. Reprobates, I'm saying narcissists or sociopaths, psychopaths, I'm just calling it reprobates, reprobates do this all the time. And when it fails, it's never them. They never want to see their adulterous attitude. They're preserving their, they're preserving their validation at all costs. That's what narcissists are doing. Narcissists put faith in anything except Christ. And when things go wrong, they're frustrated, they want someone that they can victimize to relieve themselves. That's what narcissists do. But worldly people in general do the same thing. But worldly people who are not narcissists, they can empathize with others and they tend to restrain themselves because they tend to feel responsible. While a narcissist is only interested in him or herself. A narcissist does nothing unless it benefits his or her self-validation. Even when it appears that they're giving up is only to secure that they are well-perceived by others. And the abominable thing of this world is human beings, although not humans, yes, you are human beings, but let me say, worldly people, they trust narcissists far quicker than Christ. Even when they see the narcissist cause a lot of harm, they cause suicide, they cause crime, murders, all of that, worldly people prefer listening to narcissists. Even malignant narcissists, that they listen to the Holy Spirit. Because they don't want to forfeit their idols. That's the truth. Now for you, I'm going to say it one more time because I want this to get through to you. Only have faith in Christ. Because only in Him there is true, real power. All others can only offer a cheap, debased counterfeit of the real. Only have faith in Christ. Be at peace.